As much as... Man, as much as Homer is a fat ass, at least he tried. I'm a monster! How to say that loud?
No, Lisa. The only monster here is the gambling monster that has enslaved your mother. I call him Gablor.
Gablor.
Your mother from his neon claws. Bert, where are you? Damn this casino!
Double stars. Everybody wins.
Huh, they don't know, they didn't know that could happen, casinos.
Seven. Lucky seven.
Interesting. Well.
Can't talk now.
My casino?
Fine. We'll transfer him to the nuclear plant, sir.
Oh, my beloved plant. How I miss her. Bad. To hell with this. Get my razor. Get these Kleenex boxes off my feet.
Certainly, sir. And,
Ew, and his toenails. You have a gaming problem!
You broke a promise to your child.
I look like a mess right now.
You better cry. Did I cry?
Maggie laughed. So this is just teaching you so many lessons. I just don't want to get copyright. I apologize. She has a gaming problem. That's why.
You're right, Homer. Maybe I should get some professional help.
More than professional help. I don't like to use that word. I don't.
Jingle bells, Batman smells, Robin.
And why is there a man singing for these children in the clubhouse? Awkward. Nelson's face. Oh.
Sorry, kid. Did you have a gambling problem?
First time.
That's true. Will you forgive me?
Oh, sure. Remember when I got caught stealing all those watches from Sears?
From Sears!
Because you have a gambling.
Second time, and Homer is a criminal.
Lunatic in the house because he was dressed like Santa Claus? Well,
you have a gambling problem.
When you forgive someone, you can't throw it back at them like that.
Oh, what a
jip. Oh, boy.
Remember when
I swear, I love the old Sisters episodes. I actually just got back home from the family dollar just to get myself a sandwich. A definitely good dollar was spent. And man, I feel a little bit exhausted. I think it's because of my depression, give or take. And I'm just seeing all the darn trash being over the ground. I don't know why. It makes me feel bad being an American, because in Japan, they would never do that. And in Singapore, you'll get a heavy fine if you actually do something like that. It's ridiculous. I mean, especially if you actually chew gum, you know, like in the country, because it's illegal. If you bring gum in their country, I think, from what I've heard. But besides that, I actually want to talk about four steps. Basically, addictions that affect you mentally, physically. Wait, damn, what is it? It's mentally, physically, spiritually, and society. I guess that can count. Society, the society addiction would be the gambling problem, which actually relates to Marge. The mental problem would be, damn, what was it? Oh my gosh, I forgot. Okay, so let's just say that, like me, for example, that I self-harm, even though I stopped over a year ago. Thank Buddha for that. That is a physical problem, I suppose, when it comes to me, this self-harming myself. The gambling problem would be a society problem because of how a lot of adults tend to, like, overspend their money on gambling and not taking care of their families, unfortunately, because gambling is seen as a good thing for adults. I remember watching that from, what is it, the National Lupin's Vegas Vacation? Hard to believe that we're not far from Vegas. The spiritual problem would be having a sex addiction, I suppose, because it actually affects you of building connections with other people, I think, if you watch a lot of porn and whatnot, and really being addicted to sex, and, uh-oh, I forgot what the other one is. It's a gambling addiction, sex addiction, self-harm addiction, and I don't know where the other one is. The mental problem. Uh-oh, I don't remember. Crud. The reason why I just wanted to share this episode, I deeply apologize for rambling. The thing is, for me personally, if I actually recall, Over the years, I actually gotten quite a bit of, you know, how do I say this? Some, like, addictions when it comes to eating foods, not for my mental health, I think, because of how people say that you eat out of your feelings. I'm not sure if I can actually dig it off of the trash. But the thing is, yes, I can. It's still there, because my brother has to take out the trash, and I'm feeling really depressed right now. I don't know why. I'm thinking it's because I feel as though I'm not accomplishing much in my life. The thing is, for me personally, thanks to Rollo, because he bought this for me, and I have a... Oh, excuse me, fart. I deeply apologize. And Dion, you just do your best to hang in there, because you've been going through a lot, and I have. Honestly, I used to sound like more kinder or whatnot, even though I was really kind to the workers at the Family Dollar, because I'm always that way. It's just that when you go through so much stress in your life, and you're, like, clinically depressed, your brain is kind of, like, locked in this, I want to say aggressive, this lethargic state. Like, you feel so dull, you, like, lack emotions, so to speak. Because with me being rejected by a lot of people and, you know, just being cyberbullied online and whatnot, and, I don't know, just being isolated for so long, it's just, like, my old self is just, like, gone. It's, like, he passed away, give or take. And my new self is basically my lethargic, so to speak. But for me personally, I actually discovered that I should have bought another bag. I mean, it's not really an addiction, you know, kind of is. I'm addicted to eating banana chips. And the reason I had to say this is because, I guess you could say that's a physical type of thing. I have a banana chip addiction, because my self-harm addiction, that was mentally, you know, that's also physically. The gambling one, I don't gamble. I mean, you know, I'm definitely way over the age to do so. That's society. And then sex addiction, I don't, because I'm asexual, of course. That is spiritual. The thing is, personally, after Rollo bought this bag for me, because I actually fell in love with eating these are so good. They're, like, better than Pringles, and I love Pringles. They're not as salty. They're cheaper because they're only a dollar, and there's, like, a buttload of them. Literally, I ate practically, if it's like 150 times 6, because there's supposed to be 150 calories per serving, that's equivalent of 300, 600. Dion, how much is it? Wait. For each serving. Okay, 300, 600, 900 calories. So basically, this will last me for the whole day. Imagine just eating nothing but like banana chips and noodles throughout the day, right? Because when you basically don't work, and if you live like in a region that's like below the poverty line, of course you're not gonna have as much great foods to live off on, so to speak. Because I think they say that for expensive foods, they're supposed to be healthier. But I don't know. I try not to pay attention to that, because there are expensive foods that are disgusting, give or take. But for me personally, since I met him on that day, because he was really sweet to actually buy this for me, I actually gotten hooked up on eating these. And I'm thinking, like, whenever I feel so stressed out, maybe overwhelmed, I'm gonna say stress eating, but this actually helped my anxiety or whatever. I probably would, like, it depends, like, if I'm not too depressed, because when I'm too depressed, I tend not to eat at all. The thing is that, because I have social and generalized anxiety, I was feeling so exhausted today when I was going out from a walk, because my anxiety was so far up. I was sweating like I got out from the darn pool and sunsplash. That's how bad it was. Otherwise, I would be fine. You know, because I love the heat. It's just that when you're stressed out, you feel twice as hot. So, yeah, I was burning up. It felt like it was like 120 degrees outside, not 102. You know, it's just that for me personally, I actually tend to sometimes want to eat something sweet if I ever feel maybe a little bit anxious or just overwhelmed and just want to be shut off by people, right? And banana chips, though, I've been enjoying eating these because they actually make me happy, even momentarily, because it actually takes my mind off what's going on with my stress, you know, throughout my life, of course, or throughout my day, especially if I'm watching a good episode of The Simpsons in the background. That's what I would normally would like to eat, give or take. It's kind of like how you see... Oh, excuse me. How much time I got left? Okay, good. I got like six minutes. Like the shows that you will see, My Strange Addiction, I love watching those. It sucks that there haven't been more interviews, because I'm sure there are other people out there that have like strange addictions, like eating toilet paper, which can be deadly. eating plants, like actual plants you would raise, so to speak, or I'm trying to think of something else. Maybe addicted to eating a lot of cereal, give or take. You never know. There's all different types of addictions out there, but I'm guessing for me, one of my addictions, because I go through like a lot of phases growing up. My addiction, or maybe right now, my food phase is banana chips. Because growing up, I'm thinking since, well, I'm not sure how to explain it. The thing is, for me personally, like, Deanne, how can you explain this? I remember when I was first hooked on eating orange slices, which is basically this type of candy that is shaped like an orange, you know, like a dry orange, right? But it's made of sugar. I would eat like a bag of those a day, as unhealthy as that sounds. Because whenever I would actually leave from school, because my mother, she would probably give me some money, I think. Because a dollar back then was a lot of money, right? At least for me, you know, like for a 16-year-old that never works and whatnot. I remember when I was walking back with a couple school friends, okay? I mean, I'm not in contact with them today or anything, but the thing is that when we actually walked back home, I kind of missed those days. I think that's when I was less depressed at the time. We always would go to the 7-Eleven because it would be like a hot day. This is basically like when school starts, or maybe before not before we graduate, but before the end of the school year, because it gets really hot out here in Phoenix. We always go to 7-Eleven, and they would probably just, you know, steal, like, it is technically stealing, like how you can get water for free. Because the thing is, out here in my state, Arizona, a little fun fact, that's what I like about our state. It's illegal if the, you know, the stores or the restaurants would deny people water, because we basically get hot throughout the summer. Like, it's really hot, that it's basically like an important law that we actually have here. Like, you can bring like a liter of water. Let's just say, for example, okay, you can actually, like, oh, I gotta get this out of the freezer. You can actually fill this up, and you don't have to worry about paying for anything at all, right? If they actually deny that, they can get in trouble for it, because of how heat stroke and dehydration is really, really a huge issue here where I'm from. You will probably hear the ambulance, or maybe the fire truck if there's like a fire, like, at least every day. And it's no surprise, even though we are a big city, because we're really, like, far apart. You know, we're, like, half the size of Rhode Island. We still have, like, over, like, 1.4 million people, so it's a lot. And, you know, basically that's a huge issue here, you know, because seeing that it gets really hot. So they would actually, you know, steal, like, some Mountain Dew or Cherry Coke or something. Well, for me, I always fill up my water bottle or something so that I won't pass out, because I was really out of shape, and I was taller back then, which is kind of weird that I shrunk in height. It can happen, yes, because I was much shorter than my mom, but I'm, like, shorter than her now. It's kind of weird. I would always wanted to get my favorite orange slices, right? And they were basically my favorite high school snacks at the time. And now, I actually am addicted to banana chips. I guess it's because it's like a reward for myself if I go through a lot. Because I did went through a lot back when I was in high school. It was a struggle. I mean, my junior year was, it was meh. Senior year, it was just not good, right? It's hard to explain because I had like some bad past I don't think I want to bring up though. And I'm thinking that's why, like, when we actually leave school and then I actually get home, it's just like a great feeling to actually have like a little snack, because it actually distracts you to see that you like to actually snack on it throughout the day. And after seeing that episode when Marge actually has a gaming problem, it kind of sucks, because for me having depression, I should explain this earlier, it's kind of like that. Like, Marge being addicted to gambling, it's like you're being addicted to being depressed, but you're not addicted. You're clinically depressed to the point you would be too tired. My mother, she even told me to clean the dishes. Look what's in the sink. I haven't done my dishes yet because I am so clinically depressed. Like it's like a condition. Like hunger. For someone that has never experienced depression, did this picture you having an addiction to sadness, right? Or laziness. But you basically are so upset, like, as though your dog died. Or you got an F on your ACTs. You basically are so upset You don't want to do any work? You're just thinking, oh, you know what? I'll study later because you know that you're not going to have like a good grade and you probably don't want to bar study. But you're just like upset, right? That's what depression is, kind of. So, for me personally, I feel awful because I always would stack up the dishes and I would never bother cleaning them. Plus, we're supposed to get our new curtains tomorrow, and I'm not sure where I might be filming during that time. I might be too stressed out or I might be too nervous, you know, because I like how the maintenance actually, you know, fixes our stuff, even our lights in our kitchen. But, oh no, it depends on how I feel. But I just wanted to share this because addiction is a serious deal, especially if someone has a heroin addiction or a, you know, a smoking addiction. You know, it's hard because if you go through a lot of stress in your life, as long as you're not, like, doing it to hurt others, it's hard to actually get out of that, you know, because it's something that you depend on. And I remember before I cut this off, my cousin, because I cut 20 seconds, she actually started smoking. She never did in her life after she was with her husband because she goes through a lot of stress. And I thought I could actually just share this as a person that has clinical depression himself and whatnot. I like to eat these banana chips because they make me happy, at least momentarily. And I thought I could actually share this and only paid a dollar from this. Well, we all did.